Somebody else is watching us while I'm watching for that situation, and that somebody else is SANDAG, the San Diego Association of Governments. It's a regional consortium of the cities and the county within San Diego County, and they get together and talk about, in previous years, in fact, years and years ago, I was their attorney, talking about things like transportation and water and all the other things that we would like to cooperate and do together in this region in order to simplify it, or in order to make sure that we use our money effectively. In other words, you don't want each little city doing each little transportation thing without working together. That particular well-received notion and common sense notion has now ballooned into the idea that they ought to keep track by separate police cars, specially equipped, of your movements in San Diego County by photographing your license plate, correlating it in a computer program so that they know where your car is in the course of a given day. It sounds like spying, which is what I wanted to talk to Leanne O'Neill about, UT reporter who's done some work on this. Leanne, welcome back to the program.
Thank you.
So it sounds like spying. We don't need the National Security Agency. We've got SANDAG. This is ridiculous.
Well, that's right, and they have 42 million records as of June, and that's up from 32 million in January. So they're adding 2 million or so a month.
Wow, 2 million new records. Now, records meaning?
Records means every time the police cruiser snaps a photo of your license plate, that generates one record. So 42 million license plate reads from folks just going about their ordinary business around San Diego County.
Now, as they snap those license plates, can the computer actually then map and track what you're doing and where you're going?
Well, I don't know that the computer itself can. You can join it to other data if you have somebody you're interested in. And in fact, that's what police use it for. They have hot lists of people they're trying to find, fugitives, felons, bad guys, that kind of thing. And so when a car or a vehicle pops up on the screen in the computer that they know is associated with that individual, then it gives them an alert, and then the officer goes from there.
And they also told me, when I was talking about this to Michael Robertson, who is opposed to this situation,
right,
he was saying they also do a deal where, of course, if they get a license plate of a stolen car, then they know where they can go after.
Exactly.
That.
So that seems kind of favorable if you've just had your car stolen.
Exactly. Though
I know on the other side, a lot of people are worried about privacy. They're worried about SANDAG retaining this information. And also, who could tap into that information? Could it be used for a bad purpose?
Well, that's the thing I'm kind of worried about. Once you give government information, it seems like if I'm tracking the IRS issue, for example, that they tend to use it for purposes that weren't originally intended. Any indication of that yet?
No.
You got to keep on this. I'm always suspicious of government getting too much information about private matters,
right,
and then misusing it for political
and
purposes.
And when you raise those questions with SANDAG, they say, we're very serious about security. We keep it in the same place where the FBI keeps its data.
We're going to keep after them, though. Leanne, thank you.